changes to make how our lifestyle begins nowadays. We wake up and then we, whatever, sometimes we take breakfast, sometimes we skip the breakfast, we rush to work, and we eat all kind of junk food, and all the cholesterol rich food gets deposited into our blood vessels, and into our heart, and into our brain, and all the brain organs. Many people, they smoke, and they smoke affects the entire body, all organs of the body, they are damaged by other smoke. And then a stage comes when the disease process starts its onset. So at that stage, we start getting some symptoms. And then suddenly one day, the person may have a heart attack. And then the person has to be rushed to the hospital. And then some patients, they can even get a cardiac arrest. And when you get a cardiac arrest, then you have to give shock to the heart. So you guide the heart and then you do the artificial pumping. And then the patient gets investigated, and then we suggest that patient needs a bypass surgery or patient needs stenting, and we do the procedure. Patient recovers after the procedure, and then after that goes back to work. And after a short while, again starts doing the same thing. Whatever things he was doing before in his life, he continues to do the same. And ultimately, the disease keeps on progressing, and one day his other organs of the body also get affected, and then the stage comes when he has to be rushed back to the hospital again, and then ultimately the patient dies. Ultimately, we are trying to outshine each other, and we are in competition with our colleagues. In our workplace also, we always try to move ahead of the other colleagues. So in the process, we damage each other, and then ultimately, it brings us to the end of life. So our life is just like a journey. So from birth, the journey starts, and the destination is death for everyone. But how fast we reach the destination depends on how fast we run. So if we live our life in a steady way, in a cool way, then it will take longer for us to reach the destination. But if we live, many times I've seen in my practice also that some people who are very aggressive, who are very ambitious, They are at the top of their career. Once there was a guy who became a CEO of a big firm at the age of 36. And he was like really feeling proud that at such young age, I have become the CEO of this company. And then suddenly in the medical checkup, they found that there was a small round shadow in the X-ray. And he was perfectly fit and had a very active lifestyle, but he was a smoker. And then he was referred to me, then we saw the small shadow, and we thought that there must be some tumor then which needs to be removed. And then when we removed the tumor, then the result was that he had a very aggressive cancer. So he was literally shocked that within few days his all the dreams they are shattered, and then now he has to face the disease and fight it for the rest of his life. So similarly, many people who are very aggressive, they land up with heart disease and so many other diseases. So today I will tell you what is the actual secret behind the onset of disease and what we ignore. Mostly we are not aware. So our purpose is to create awareness. So that is actually the journey of life according to the healthcare needs. So here you can see below, you can see that if you see that straight line, that is actually the journey of life. In the early life, right from birth until death, there are various stages at which we can take care of our health. So first is the primordial prevention. Primordial prevention is when we are in the early age of our life, in childhood, when there is no risk factor of the disease and there is no disease. So that is the stage when we should be made aware about the risk factors and about the etiology, about how disease occurs. So if we are made aware, we can prevent risk factors from entering our life. Next stage comes the primary prevention. In primary prevention, there already is onset of the risk factors, but there is no disease as yet. So this is the stage when we know there are the risk factors and we can control the risk factors. So once we control the risk factors, we can prevent the progress into the next stage. So if still we are not able to control, then the next stage comes, which is early diagnosis. Early diagnosis means that just when the disease is about to start, we identify the disease, we diagnose the disease, and we start taking proper treatment. So proper treatment may be simple, like it may be some corrective measures, some lifestyle changes, or maybe some small medication which may help you in preventing you from going to the next stage. So next stage is the medical management stage, where you need a proper treatment prescription, you have to take the medicine, and then you may prevent yourself from going to the further stage. So next stage is the stage of intervention. Like intervention is required when we get a complication of the disease, like person gets a heart attack, or person gets a frank cancer, and then we need surgery, or we need some stenting, or some bypass surgery, radiotherapy, or some chemotherapy. So that stage, if we can identify the disease at an early stage, then the treatment will be less complicated. But if we come late to the hospital, then the treatment becomes more complicated and the chances of having further complications also increase. So after the intervention is there, and once we recover from an intervention, then what is the next stage? The next stage is rehabilitation. Rehabilitation means that person has successfully undergone some intervention, is now recovering, but has to be brought back to the same condition in which he was before the onset of the disease. So somebody is working in an office, so after intervention he should be able to resume his duty, should be able to perform the same duty which he was doing before the onset of the disease. And after the rehabilitation, the next stage is the secondary prevention. This is very important, because once you have the disease and you come back to work and start enjoying your normal life, then we should take preventive measures so that you don't get the disease again. So suppose you have a heart attack, you don't get a second heart attack, and if you get a cancer, you don't get the recurrence of the cancer, or you may not get another cancer or another disease. So all these stages are very important. So if we take the average lifespan of a person in India, it is say about 62 or 64 years. But if we go to Japan or if we go to USA, the average lifespan of a person is about 90 years. So why those people are living 30 years more than us? So there has to be some reason, because they are quite similar to us. They have the same body, same organs. They eat similar kind of food and they do similar kind of work. Then why they are living 30 years more than us? So we have to look into this matter.